Children, we are starting circle today. Okay, so you know what is a circle? It is a closed figure. Okay, so it has a center, here O. So distance of any point, this line is called circumference. All right, so the area within the circumference is called circle. Now the distance of the center from any point on the circumference is always same, equal. Okay, so that's a circle. So here the distance between the center and any point here on circumference is called the radius. So radius is the distance between center and any point on the circumference. So if a line passes through a center, suppose AB passes through center O, then the length of AB is called diameter. Okay, so diameter is the distance between any two points on the circle through center. Okay, so any line passing through the center, all right, in a circle is called diameter. And now you know what is radius, what is diameter, what is circumference. C stands for circumference, remember. Circumference is this line, okay, length of this boundary. Now, in any circle, the ratio of circumference to diameter is always constant. Whether you take small circle or big circle, but when you take the ratio of circumference to diameter, it is always same. So, that's constant. So, that constant is represented by a Greek letter pi. Okay. So, the exact value of pi is not known, okay, and cannot be found out. So, it is an irrational number. So, we take approximate values. In fraction, we take 22 by 7. And in decimal, we take 3.14. So, for our purposes, we take 22 by 7 by 3.14. Now, in the question, if the value of pi is given, then you take that value. If the value of pi is not given, then you always take 22 by 7. Okay? Normally, value of pi is given in the question. If not given, take 22 by 7. Now some important relations. So as from the diagram you see diameter, this is radius, this also radius. So diameter is what? Radius plus radius, that is 2r. So d equal to 2r. That means diameter is double of radius, means radius is half of diameter. So r equal to d by 2. So if you know diameter, you can find radius. If you know radius, if diameter is asked, you can find out diameter. Okay, if you know diameter, you can find radius here. If you know radius, you can find diameter. Now, circumference from this definition here. Okay, so if you cross multiply pi into d, you get c equal to pi d. And you know d equal to 2r. So if you put the value of d 2r here, so you get pi into 2r, that is equal to 2 pi r. So we take this as formula of circumference. So circumference formula is what? C equal to 2 pi r. And the formula of area is pi r square. That you have to remember. Remember, don't get confused. Area is two dimensional, so the unit is centimeter square or meter square, so r square is here. And circumference is the simply length, so only r is there. Okay? So, that's about circle. Now, if you take a ring, ring has two concentric circles here. The shaded region is called the ring. Okay? So, only the shaded region is called the ring. So, here we have two concentric circles. Alright. So, one is bigger, one is smaller. So, radius of the bigger circle we take capital R. And radius of the smaller circle we take small r. And the difference of these two, here, the width of the ring. Okay, width of the ring we represent by D. So, D equal to R minus R. That means capital R minus small r. And area of ring is, this shaded region, that is. So, if you subtract area of smaller circle from the area of the bigger circle, we get area of ring. So, pi r square is the biggest area of bigger circle. Pi r small r square is the area of smaller circle. If you subtract, you get area of ring. So, area of ring formula is pi bracket root over r square minus small r square. Okay. Now, semicircle. Semicircle means half of the circle. Okay, so its perimeter is this circumference c by 2, half of the circumference plus diameter. Okay, perimeter is half of circumference plus diameter. So circumference is pi r, so half of circumference will be, circumference is 2 pi r, so half of circumference will be 2 pi r by 2, so 2 cancel, so pi r plus d equal to 2 r. If you take r common, you get pi plus r. Okay, now area equal to, you know, full circle is pi r square, so half circle is half pi r square. Now quadrant of a circle. So this is quadrant, means quarter of a circle. So here it is r. So perimeter is, this is 1/4 of circumference, is 1/4 of 2 pi r. Okay, and here you have 2 r's here, so 2 r. So 2 will cancel here 2 times. So half pi r plus 2 r is the formula of perimeter. Okay, and here area is, the full circle is pi r square, so this is 1/4. So 1 by 4 pi r square. So these are the formulas which you need to remember. You read question very carefully. See whether full circle is given, or semicircle is given, or quadrant is given, or ring is given. Accordingly, you have to choose the correct formula. So in mensuration, you have to know formulas by heart. Okay, then only you will be able to do the sums. So note down these formulas and learn by heart. Now let's take some questions to see the applications. Okay, questions are there. I have written the question in short form to save space and time. You can find these questions on your book. Now, question number one says, find the radius of a circle, okay, and area of a circle if circumference of that circle is 18 pi centimeter. Find the radius and area of a circle if its circumference is 18 pi centimeter. So what is given? So here, C is equal to 18 pi given centimeter, unit is centimeter. Okay, so suppose let R be the radius. Whenever radius is not given, always suppose R to be radius. So therefore C equal to 2 pi R, 2 pi R equal to then 18 pi. Okay, because C is the circumference, formula is 2 pi R, it's a full circle. So this implies R equal to 18 pi by 2 pi. So pi will get cancelled. So 2 will go 9 times. So R equal to 9 centimeters. So this is the first answer. Then question is to find the area. So therefore, area is equal to pi R square. So pi into 9 square. So that is 81 pi. So you can write in terms of pi. So unit is centimeter square. Okay. Because it's area. Okay. So now let's take question number 2. Now question number 2 says, find the radius and the circumference of a circle if its area is 144 pi centimeter square. In the previous circumference was given, now area is given. So here area is equal to 144 pi centimeter square. So radius is not given. So let R be the radius. Okay. So area given means, what is the formula? It is pi R square equal to 144 pi. That means R square equal to 144 pi divided by pi. So pi will get cancelled. So 144. This implies R equal to root over 144, that is 12. So radius is positive, so we take positive. So 12 centimeters. So this is the first answer, radius. Then find circumference. So therefore, C is equal to 2 pi R. So 2 pi into radius is 12. So 24 pi centimeter. You can leave answer in terms of pi because it's given in terms of pi here. Okay. Now, if the value pi is provided, then you can put the value pi also in that case. Now, next number 3. Now, if area of a semicircle is 77 centimeter square, find perimeter. Now, it is a semicircle and its area is 77 centimeter square. Find the perimeter. Perimeter means length of all boundaries. Okay, perimeter of circle is circumference, but here this diameter is also there, so we call it perimeter only, not circumference, because it's not a circle. So here what is given, area is equal to 77 centimeter square. So radius is not given, so let R be the radius. Okay, so area of semicircle means it is half of a circle, so we take half pi r square equal to 77. Okay, so we'll find the radius here first, because the question says find the perimeter. So to find the perimeter, we have to know length of radius. Okay, so this will give you r square equal to 77 into 2. Okay, before that, I think it will be better if you put the value of pi here. Okay, so 1 by 2 into 22 by 7 into r square equal to 77. So it will be easier. So r square equal to 77, this 2 and 7 will go up and 22 will come down, cross multiplication. This denominator will go up to numerator and numerator goes down to denominator. So 2 will go here 11 times and 11 will go here 7 times. So r square equal to 7, 7 means r equal to 7 centimeter. So radius is found. Now question says find the perimeter. So you know perimeter of this semicircle is, it is c by 2, c by 2 half of the circumference plus 2r, means this is diameter 2r. So this is the formula. So 2 pi r by 2 plus 2r, this implies 2 to cancel, so pi r plus 2r. So pi r, if you take r common, you can directly take this formula, r into pi plus 2. So r is equal to, we have 7 into 22 by 7 is the value of pi plus 2. So 7 into, if you take LCM, 7 here, so 22 plus 7 2s are 14. So 7, 7 cancel. So 22 plus 14 will be 36 centimeters. So this will be the answer. Okay. Now, next question. That is number 4. In number 4, see, diagram is given here. So let's draw the diagram again to understand. So there are two diameters here. They intersect at right angles. So these two areas are stated here. These two regions are shaded. Okay, so A, B, C, and D named. This is, or you can say, center. Now, question says area of shaded portion is 308 centimeters square. So here, area of shaded portion is equal to 308 centimeter square. So now, since they intersect right angle, so it's a quadrant, so there are two quadrants. So area of two quadrants, so radius is not given first, suppose, you suppose the radius, let R be the radius. Okay, so we have to find the perimeter. Okay, perimeter of the shaded region. So we'll find R first. Then, area 1 quadrant is 1 by 4 pi r square. So since there are two quadrants, into 2 is equal to 308, because 1 by 4 pi r square is the area of only one quadrant. So there are two, so we multiply by 2. So 2 will cancel here 2 times. So 1 by 2 into 22 by 7 into r square equal to 308. So this implies r square equal to 308 into 2 into 7 by 22. Okay, 2 will go here 11 times. So 11 will go here, 11 2s are 22, 8, 11 8s are 8. Okay, so this implies r square equal to 28 is equal to 4 into 7 into 7. So this implies r equal to square root of 4 is 2 into, from 2 7 you get 1 7. So equal to 14 centimeter. Now we have to find the perimeter. So therefore, perimeter equal to, so here this is 1/4 of circumference and 1/4 of circumference. Okay, so you have 1 by 4c plus 1 by 4c. Then plus how many r you have? 1 r, 2, 3, 4. So plus 4 r. This is the perimeter of this shaded region. Okay, so if you simplify here, 1 4th plus 1 4 will be half c plus 4 r, that is 2 pi r by 2 plus 4 r. That will be equal to 2 to cancel. So 22 by 7 into 14 plus 4 into 14, because r is 14. So 7 will cancel it 2 times. So 2 into 22 will be 44 plus 4 4s are 16, 4 1s are 4, 5. So 56. So 56 plus 44 is how much? It is 100 centimeter is the answer. Okay. Now we'll take I took this question here. Find AC. Okay, this is not asked, so anyway, it doesn't matter. So AC equal to, now AC equal to, AC is the diameter, so this is equal to 2R, so it's equal to 2 into 14 equal to 28 centimeter. Actually, this is not asked here, this part is not asked perimeter. If asked, then you can find this way. Okay, so AC is asked, AC equal to 28 centimeter, and circumference, so this is an answer number 1 and answer number 2. Circumference is 2 pi r equal to 2 into 20 by 7 into 14, equal to 7 will go 2 times, so 2 is a 4, 4 into 2, 8, 4, 8, 88 centimeter is the circumference. Okay, so this is question 4 now complete. Now we take the last question for the day, that is number 5. In number 5, circumference is given, C equal to 123.2 centimeter. Calculate radius, calculate R, okay, radius and area in nearest centimeter square. And also it says effect on area if R is doubled. So how area will change if radius is doubled? So let's first find out radius. Okay, so let R be the radius. Okay, now C equal to, therefore C equal to, this means C equal to 2 pi R equal to 123.2. okay, so whether the value of R is given or not, let's check in the question here. Okay, so value of pi. So value of pi is not given. So we take 22 by 7. Okay. So this implies 2 into 22 by 7 into R equal to 123.2. So R equal to then 123.2 into 7 by 2 into 22. Okay, you can calculate this one easily by doing some rough work. So here 123.2 into 7 will give you 862.4 divided by 44. So if you divide by 44, so you get 19.6 centimeters. So this is the radius, the first answer. Now area, so answer number 2. So therefore area equal to pi r square, so 22 by 7 into radius is 19.6 square. So 22 by 7 into, so 19.6 into 19.6 is equal to, it is 384.16. So if you simplify, then you get into 22 will give you 8451.52 divided by 7. So if you divide by 7, so you get 1207.36 centimeter square. Okay, but question says correct to nearest meter centimeter square. So if you know if the last digit 5 or more, then you know when you round it up, then you know 1 is added to the preceding digit. So 6 more than 5, so it becomes 4. 4 is less than 5, so simply it is omitted. So what you get? 1207 centimeter square in nearest centimeter square answer. Okay. Now number 3. Effect of area if R is double. So when radius is R, area equal to how much? Pi R square. So when radius is double, means 2R, then area will be how much? Pi into 2R square. That is 4 pi R square. That means area of the previous circle is pi r square, so it is 4 pi square means 4 times. That means 4 pi square means this is the area of the previous area of circle when radius is r. That means when you take 2r, it becomes 4 times. So therefore, area increases 4 times. If you double the radius, area will increase 4 times. Okay, so area increases 4 times. All right, that is the answer. Okay.